bless y'all. So I have to share this dream that I had. My birthday was October 2nd. Pertaining to that, a couple days before, the spiritual attacks have just been outrageous, really outrageous. It's been very strong, right? October 4th, it was kind of a peak for me as far as spiritual attacks. And I don't remember when I had this dream, but I had this dream. I was with my wife and we're running a race and we're about to finish, but literally right about to finish and we dropped out of the race. And there were some other people, and I don't remember exactly what they told us, but I think it was like, hey, what are you doing? Like, get back in the race. And then I think I remember saying something like, we'll be right back. We'll be right back. And then anyway, I might be wrong. Forgive me if I'm wrong. But for sure, we were running a race. We dropped out and some people confronted us and I told them something. And then we didn't get back in the race. And the dream ended. Anyway, pertaining to that, y'all, now's not the time. Now's not the time to get out of the race that God has called us to. There are certain callings that each of us have as the body of Christ, and we need to persevere. We need to press in. We need to endure until the end because the trumpet's about to blow. Don't give up. The day of Christ is fast approaching, and man, there's so much. And these things, momentary afflictions, they're nothing compared to the glory that is about to be revealed. So strive to enter in through the narrow gate. I don't know what you're going through, and I'm not trying to downplay in the troubles of this life. We all are going through tribulation and we're weary. We're trying to press into the presence of Christ. But if you're shrinking back from faith, you need to repent right now and draw near to Christ even harder. Force yourself to do it. There's a principle regarding spirituality that I have learned in opposing to the natural realm. With the natural man, if you're hungry, you eat and you lose that hunger. You're satisfied. Eventually, you become hungry again. With the spiritual, it's the opposite. If you're hungry, it's because you're eating and you're going to keep eating. So likewise, if you're not hungry, it's because you're not eating and you're lacking eating. You need to eat of the bread of life. You need to drink of the living water of Jesus Christ. It's time to press into Jesus Christ. Just like it is with the natural man, if you're not eating, you're getting hungry. It's the opposing with the spirit. You need to force yourself into the presence of God. You need to kill the flesh and the desires of it. You need to press in. As Jesus said, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. And what did he say? Pray for 1 hour. He said, you couldn't pray for 1 hour. So force yourself to draw into the presence of the Lord. This is not a time to be playing, because the day of the Lord is near and it's fast approaching. And we see all the signs, and he's given us so much signs and wonders, and he's confirmed things through many believers, through even you watching this video. You're probably watching this because God has been showing you that he's coming and the time is near. It's at hand. He's about to blow the trumpet. He's about to descend in the clouds with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God. The dead in Christ are going to rise, and we who are alive and remain are going to be caught up. So don't shrink back, because we are not appointed unto wrath, but to receive salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. And because if we keep the word of his patience to endure, he's going to keep us from the hour of testing that's coming to test the inhabitants of the earth. And we need to watch and take heed, lest our hearts be weighed down with drunkenness, carousing, and the cares of this life, and that day come upon us unawares. For it's going to come as a snare. It's going to come as a trap upon all those that dwell on the face of the earth. And we need to watch and pray that we be accounted worthy to escape all that shall come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man, because only they who endure to the end shall be saved. It is time. It is time, because judgment is going to begin in the house of God. So repent of your sins. Draw near to Christ. Forsake the former way of living. Do not live in the former lusts of the flesh. Crucify the deeds of the flesh and live by the Spirit. God bless you, brothers and sisters. May the Holy Spirit guide you and lead you and protect you from all deceit. The blood of Jesus cover you. And may we all be counted worthy to escape all that shall come to take place here on this earth. And may the blood of the Lamb of the living God cleanse our minds and our consciousness, that we may approach the throne of grace of God with boldness and confidence in Jesus Christ and not of ourselves, because he is holy. Hallelujah. Be holy, for he is holy. God bless you. In Jesus' name.